Welcome everybody. This is the tutorial video number 2, basic steps to produce a whistling sound. Whatever the whistling style, with or without the ends, there are a number of steps which will produce many kinds of whistling sounds, if they are well applied. To produce a whistling sound, we may use a gun bullet, a drinking glass, a piece of grass, a leaf, our lips with or without the ends or else. All these possibilities share the same general steps to be learned. Understanding these steps permits us to learn how to produce the whistling sounds in a multitude of ways limited only by our imagination. Before we can master the melodic whistling, we need first to produce a single whistling sound, and I am proposing you 3 steps to reach that goal. 1. The positioning step. 2. The blowing step. 3. The conversion step. The first step, the positioning, consists to place the elements to produce the whistling. For example, to whistle with a technique using hands, we need to know how to place the hands properly. It is the same thing for the lips, the tongue, the object, a piece of grass, a leaf, etc. Usually, a whistler mastering the wanted whistling style will be capable to give all the instructions useful for the positioning step. The second step, the blowing step, is to blow, generally by breathing air in, inhale, or out, expire. That step may seem obvious. However, there are things to be controlled, like the power of the blow and the complete trajectory the air is following. As for the first step, whenever it is possible, we may follow the instruction from a whistler mastering that wanted whistling style. Do not worry if you didn't succeed to produce a whistling sound yet. The step 3 is designed to cure that problem. I named that step the conversion step because the objective is to start from the steps 1 and 2 and to make a convergence toward the wanted whistling sound to be produced. Many tutorials are suggesting to vary lightly the positioning and the blowing until a whistling sound is reached. That process appears to be a random one. I have found an improved method to convert to the result in a faster and less random way. To proceed, we need to listen to the sound produced by 2 variations of the combination positioning and blowing. At the beginning, we choose larger variations. After listening, we choose the variation which we judge are more resembling to a whistling sound. By repeating that procedure with variations more and more precise, the whistling sound will be heard in a natural way a first time, and then following with that first success, we can make it more precise with the same process until the whistling sound may be reproduced in each trial. It is important to realize that the brain is using recursively what is heard to learn to produce a sound. The memorization of the required movements of the many parts of the body is a process to reproduce the wanted sound. The fact to make that exercise with effective attention is or awareness is fastening that process. Once trained to do it, learning a new technique to whistle will become accessible in a relatively short time, which will perhaps surprise you. Now, it remains to apply the steps in a practical example. That is ending the video number 2. Thank you for the listening of this video. Let's have fun to whistle and let's start the music.